Bonjour, ça va? Ça va bien. Quel temps fait-il? Quel temps fait-il? What is the weather like? Il fait beau. And tell me, qu'est-ce que tu portes? What are you wearing? Qu'est-ce que tu portes? And now you can tell me, je porte un jean ou un t-shirt. Oh, maybe mon uniforme d'école, my school uniform. Bon, today is the last lesson in book two, so we actually worked a lot this year. So it's the last lesson dans le livre deux, and then we are going to do a general lesson about everything that you can say about yourself and what you learn, and then the last lesson of the year will be une leçon de Noël, of all the festivals and especially of Christmas. So let's see what we can eat. So your lesson. C'est à la page 35. Remember, you can't do the lesson if you don't have the pages. So ask maman et papa to print them out for you, s'il vous plaît. On page 35, you see we have les galettes et les crêpes. So this lesson is about food. And I think you've all heard the word les crêpes. So that's like a pancake. That's what the French people call a pancake in France. Okay, les galettes is a little thicker pancake, and they use that more or less for savory fillings. Les galettes. Now remember I told you last time, les and les, that means plural. Now what can you put into your galette or your crêpe? Is look at the top, des champignons, some mushrooms, say that, champignons, des champignons. Or maybe, peut-être, des tomates, or maybe some cheese, du fromage, or some ham, du jambon, and maybe eggs, des œufs. Now, an egg in French is un œuf. You say the F when it's in the singular. Un œuf. But when it becomes plural, you don't pronounce the F. You say des œufs. Des œufs. You take over the S of the D. Des œufs. Then, I think those were all for the galette. Now, for the crêpe, we have du citron. Du citron. Lemon, du sucre, some sugar, du sucre, des fraises, peut-être, some strawberries, du chocolat, chocolate, et de la crème, cream. Now, maybe it's strange for you now because some of the words now have a D and some have a D. That is just the way that the French pronounce some. So it's actually, if I talk about cheese, it's actually le fromage. But if I talk about some cheese, I'll talk about du fromage. Don't worry a lot about that. Just, if you just knew the name, like le citron and le sucre, les fraises, then it's fine. Bon, let's go over them again. Mushrooms, des champignons. Tomatoes, des tomates. Cheese, du fromage. Ham, du jambon, some eggs, des œufs, and some lemon, du citron, some sugar, du sucre, some strawberries, des fraises, some chocolate, du chocolat, and some cream, de la crème. And you already know about ice cream, it can be de la glace. Whatever you want to put into your bank. Bon, let's go to page 36. And there they explain les galettes. So read with me, savory pancakes. In France, there are lots of places which sell les galettes. Galettes are savory pancakes made using wholemeal flour, but you can actually use any flour. And the French have a very big round pancake pan. And all over on the streets, everywhere you find people making these big pancakes on big pans and then putting the fillings in. And then the French people, they put it in a little packet and they walk like that and they eat it. Sometimes they make the whole breakfast into a galette. They put a jambon and everything inside it and they eat it on their way to work. Bon. So now they only want you to copy all the words and to draw a drawing of that just to remember what it is. So the first one is du fromage. So copy du fromage and then you draw a picture of cheese. The second one will be du jambon. You can copy and draw. Des œufs, eggs. Des tomates, tomatoes. Et des champignons. So you can color it in. And imagine that you are going to make a galette with all these lovely fillings. And then draw it. If you write it, you draw it, and you pronounce it, you'll remember it better. Bon, you can do that after the lesson. Maintenant, page 37. Now, you remember we learned how to say, I like something and I want something. So if I want something, I will say, je voudrais. I would like. So how do I buy a galette in France? I say, je voudrais une galette, s'il vous plaît. Je voudrais une galette. But now they are going to ask you what you want inside. So then you use the little word avec. When Thomas speaks, you can see avec. Maybe you can highlight it. Je voudrais une galette avec. Avec means with. Avec. Even if you go to the park with mama and papa, you could say avec maman et papa. Or I go to the cinema with my friends, you will say avec mon ami. Right? Avec, then some cheese, du fromage et du jambon. Je voudrais une galette, read with me. Je voudrais une galette avec du fromage et du jambon, s'il vous plaît. Okay, what is Marie buying? Je voudrais une galette avec des tomates et du fromage. So what must be in her galette? Tomatoes and cheese. Très bien. And let's see what Luc buys. Luc says, je voudrais une galette avec des champignons et du jambon, s'il vous plaît. I would like a galette with mushrooms and ham. Oui. Anne, what does Anne buy? Read with me. Je voudrais une galette avec des tomates et des œufs, s'il vous plaît. Remember, you don't say the F in the plural, des œufs. So, what is in her galette? Tomatoes and eggs. And then Paul. Je voudrais une galette avec du jambon, du fromage, des œufs et des champignons, s'il vous plaît. I would like a galette with ham and cheese. And eggs and mushrooms. That's a whole breakfast in one galette. And they usually fold it, you know, if the galette is round, they first fold it in the middle, then it's like a, a half moon, yeah? And then they fold it again. Then it's like a triangle, and they put it in a packet like that, and then they eat it. Très bien. Now they want us to complete le tableau. We now have to complete le tableau. What is Thomas eating? What is Marie eating? What is Luc eating? What is Anne eating? And what is Paul eating? And then you can draw another column there for yourself. What are you eating? If you have to buy a galette in France, what are you going to put inside? So let's see. Thomas, what did he choose? Fromage and jambon. And what did Marie choose? Just look again. Tomate et fromage. And what did Luc choose? Champignon et jambon. Anne liked to have tomate and eggs in her galette. And Paul liked champignon, fromage, jambon, and œufs. So he had four things in. And now you can order your own galette. Je voudrais une galette veg with la 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 la, whatever you want. You can have that galette. And you can ask your mother now, Maman, je voudrais une galette avec. And tonight, you can tell your parents what's the difference between a galette, a savory pancake, and a crêpe is a sweet pancake. Bon appétit. I hope you have a nice, nice meal with that. Bon. Page 38. On page 38, they now explain to you sweet pancakes. Les crêpes. Say that. Les crêpes. And they explain to you, in France, sweet pancakes are called les crêpes, and they're usually made with white flour, a little lighter flour, but we can do it any way that you like. So let's see what they put in the sweet pancakes. Du citron, can you remember? That's a lemon. Du sucre, they want you to copy the words. Du sucre. Then des fraises. Then de la crème, cream. And du chocolat. Let's say that again. Du citron. Du sucre. Des fraises, de la crème et du chocolat. Très bien. So now, if you order a sweet pancake, you will say, je voudrais une crêpe avec. Can you remember that avec? Je voudrais une crêpe avec. I will say avec du sucre et du citron. With sugar and lemon. You can say avec des fraises et du chocolat. Très bien. Now, they juggle the words at the bottom. Réarranger les lettres pour trouver le mot. So, they made it sort of mix it up. And now, you have to say which word it is. It's one of the fillings of the crêpe. So, see if you can see the first one. They gave it to you. It's sucre. The second one. Just pause the video before I give the answer. And then you see it for yourself. You look for it. That is chocolat. Numéro C, du citron. Et numéro D, des fraises. Très bien, très bien. Voilà. Page 39. On the top of page 39, you have qu'est-ce que vous voulez? What would you like? Qu'est-ce que vous voulez? What would you like? There's again qu'est-ce que and vous voulez, but you can just remember je voudrais. So now you order a sweet pancake. Je voudrais une crêpe avec, and then you put in de la crème, du chocolat, des fraises, whatever you want inside. It's imaginary pancakes, so you can have anything. You can have all of them if you want. Bon. Now we have again les filles et les garçons. And we have to follow the lines with our fingers. And then we have to see now. Numéro 1. If you look, maybe it's Sylvie. Look what she wants. Go with your finger. Chocolat. So what will her sentence be? They gave it the sentence. Je voudrais une crêpe avec du chocolat, s'il vous plaît. Je voudrais une crêpe avec du chocolat, s'il vous plaît. Très bien. And Paul, let's see what Paul wants. Let's go, go, go with your finger. What is Paul? Oh, des fraises. So what will his sentence be? Je voudrais une chocolat, une crêpe avec du chocolat. Remember, you can write it afterwards. And Amandine, numéro C. I think it's, what do you see? Sucre. Oui? What will her sentence be? Je voudrais une crêpe avec du sucre. Étienne. Let's see what Étienne wants. Go with your finger. Crème. Je voudrais un chocolat avec de la crème. Et let's see the last one. Laure. Go with your finger. Oh, I see le citron. So, she will say, think about the sentence. Je voudrais une crêpe avec du citron. Now, if you want two things, Remember the A? You said you put the A inside, in between. You said, je voudrais une crêpe like me. I like a sugar and lemon pancake. So I will say, je voudrais une crêpe avec du sucre et du citron. Très bien. Très bien. So you can write it. Take your time and write it at the end. And see that you are able to order a pancake. Oh, last page of this book, page 40. On page 40, you have your word search. Let's look for the words at the bottom that you have to look for. See if you can still understand everything. Jambon, fromage, œufs, tomate, champignon, galette, chocolat, crème, fraise, citron, sucre, crêpe. Remember to write your time. Remember now to explain to Mama and Papa what is the difference between a galette and a crêpe. Then at the end of the lesson, there's a pancake recipe that I usually make that I put in for you in French. Try to make it. But otherwise, just take Maman's favorite recette and then you make crêpe and you put in all the nice fillings and then you ask everybody in home to tell you which crêpe they want and what they would like for that. Bon, I hope you enjoyed. And if you tell someone in French to have a nice meal, you say bon appétit. Say that. Bon appétit. Encore. Bon appétit. Voilà. Au revoir.